Hi, this is Amjad. This short video will help us understand what we mean by social policies and social protection, development. So we'll try to do it in very accessible way. And this will serve us as the big picture for the course that we will work on, the course on social policies and social protection. So I'll do it in very accessible way. So we'll use a metaphor just to help us understand the big picture. So when we talk about development, or let's talk about economic growth as a very important component in development. I want you to think of economic growth as if it was this train. So obviously countries, they part of their policy objective is to get this train moving forward. So we need to ignite economic growth, unleash the potential of the country. Once you have economic growth moving forward, it will create jobs for people will start generating income, and then this income will work as a multiplier. So very important that countries achieve economic growth, so this will help to reduce poverty and improve the well-being of everyone. So the first objective we wanted in this course, that we will look at how we ignite economic growth, or drivers for economic growth. So we look at this one as we move on. So once the train moves on, once we understand what are the drivers of economic growth, what we would recognize that there is a pattern of people who are able to benefit from this economic growth. I want you to look at this picture. Remember, this metaphor tells us about the economic growth that is represented by the train. Now the train started moving, economic growth started happening in the country, people try to catch. And if you look at the pattern of people who are able to catch on the train, you would see, or the ones they try to catch on the train, you see they are young, and you see men. Or let's look at who are the ones excluded. You would see, we don't see women, right? And this is true. In economic growth, if it's left without any government intervention, it naturally discriminates against female labor force participants. It might be, you know, like the community, you know, like they have culture that, okay, this job is for men, you cannot go there, you know. So it's, again, it might be like a cultural barrier, it might be explicit law that discriminates against female labor force participants. But in general, what we need to recognize that if there is no social policies accompanying the economic growth, it will discriminate against female, not only female, but also person with disability. Right? Persons with disability will be discriminated against. You might also think of senior citizen. We don't see seniors here, but senior citizens will be discriminated against. They're not in the labor market, so they're not benefiting from what the economic growth is offering. So we need to have redistributive measures to make sure that they are included. It might be also like migrant, legal, illegal migrant, or in minorities, whatever, you know, like the form of division in the society, you know, like whether it's stratification based on social, gender, but minorities will be discriminated against. In this maybe metaphor, it might be in this station that there is a discrimination, you know, you give the priorities to the locals before, you know, you allow foreigner migrant worker, or before you allow the anyone from the minority, you create first space for the ones from the dominant ethnicity, or similar things like this. But this is exactly, you know, again, like the issue of economic growth. If it's left without any government intervention, it will be discriminatory. It will result in bias against certain groups. You might see also there's a child here, a father with a child. It's also like labor market, economic growth, it will disadvantage families especially with little one. It does not cater for their needs. So it favors young people and men, but not families with children. And this is something important for us to keep it in our mind as we move in looking at different policy instruments that are used to create inclusivity in the labor market. Moving forward, now these kids, young people, manage to get into the train. It doesn't mean that you have managed to get a job in the city, that you will have a comfortable ride, that you will have a very good condition. And this is exactly if, again, another issue related to economic growth, if it's left unrestricted without accompanying policies to ensure that it's more decent for labor force participants. It will be hazardous, right? This is very hazardous, right? So they are able to get into the train, but it's very hazardous. Somebody drops, we need to make sure that now he or she will have the form of disability or work-related injuries. We need to make sure that there is a social protection system, that the loss of income will be or the welfare loss will be offset with a stream of income through social protection, whether social insurance or tax finance, but through instrument that will allow them to not to fall in deep poverty because of work-related injury. So we need to have social protection for the people who work in the modern economy. But as you notice that here, it's not a very comfortable ride. It's very hazardous. In the very same train, you would see people that they are doing more than good. They're doing great, fabulous. They are enjoying a very comfortable ride. They have more than what they need. How they ended up there, maybe they inherited some wealth that they were able to have an advantage, or maybe they have the skill set that is rewarded in the labor market. Maybe they have connections and you know they were able to get contracts when the economy is expanded. So in any case, they grew at higher rate than the rest. And this is like inequality has been an issue that discussed extensively, because we've seen that inequality is everywhere is rising. Many people, they are benefiting more than others. So what is social policy or social protection as well? What is it? Firstly, we need to remember the first objective. We need to ignite economic growth. Economic growth is very important. So we need to have policies that will give momentum to the train, keep going, right? To unleash the potential of the country. That's the first objective. Second objective, we need now the policies that no one left behind. So we need economic growth to move forward, but we need no one left behind. Women, senior citizens, we looked at those groups, families with children, persons with disability, we need them to be included. Third objective, the ones they are in the labor market, we need to have sort level of protection, health, work-related injury, maternity, you know, they need to be protected when they are working in the modern economy. And how we will fund this? Through taxation. Some people, they are having more than a comfortable ride. Countries tax, so they can, you know, create an average maybe between these two situation, where it would look something like this. It's comfortable, not very comfortable, but work is not comfortable for all of us, but it's not hazardous. It's still decent. An able person, is a young man, is able, this youth, to stand, so he will stand. The professional lady is standing, she's not excluded, she is in the train, in the economic growth. You see lots of ladies as well here. You see a senior citizen also, they are included in the train. And this is where you have policies. If you look in the train, you'll see policies. You will see like a designated area for senior citizens, designated area for mothers with or expecting mothers, another one for families with little ones. So the train is inclusive. So there are certain set of rules here that you would accommodate the needs of specific people, whether person of disability, that designated area will help them to be seated in the train. So we moved from a train that like this and excluding women and other groups and this into a train like this. By taxing these guys, we were able to do this. We need also to be a little bit also practical here. There is a need for some disparity. Disparity is not all of it, it's bad. Sometimes disparity gives the signal for people to shift to different careers, to restructuring the economy, the signal to work hard, and it needs to be rewarded. It's not necessarily you wanted to have this, but at least we need to have a first class, right? And this is exactly what you see here. It's not as outrageous as the picture I showed you before, but it's, you know, it gives a signal for those they prefer to go, you know, like to show some wealth. So. But at least, you know, the combination between this, no one is left behind, you can come here, and if you want to afford, you can go for a first class. So this is in essence what we mean by really social policy, and this is what we will be talking about in this course. So basically, the first topic we will talk about in next session, we'll start looking at how economic growth can be ignited, how we can unleash economic growth. We'll use a very simple way to, you know, like to help us understand it, but in very systematic way, in a way that is, it helps us, you know, like to create some thinking of certain policies that we need to focus on. But we'll spend a lot of time on how to make the economic growth inclusive, what policies, what interventions, how the government can intervene in a way that balances a set of objectives. So we look at what are these objectives and how we can create a balanced approach in the economy to make it more inclusive. And this is really what we will be talking about in this course. See you in another session.